You know the day destroys the night, night divides the day. Try to run, try to hide, break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side, yeah.
Eat makes a move. It could be a man, woman, a louse, an elephant. On the other hand, a Go PC has only a milieu of exteriority, of extrinsic relations with nebulas or constellations occurs to which it fulfills functions of insertion or situations such as bordering, encircling, shattering, all by itself.
Thanks to social and technological progress, most Chinese are shifting from traditional to more modern forms of entertainment. But some traditional Chinese games, most notably Go and Chinese chess, have remained popular to the present day. Playing Go and Chinese chess can be both amusing and intellectually challenging. But more importantly, playing these games helps you learn how to respond to change, keep your wits about you, and take into consideration the overall picture in a given situation. Now, these games have always represented an idea, an attitude, and a state of mind.
但是呢，姚有一个儿子，他的儿子叫丹珠，这个丹珠呢，这不学好，啊，这个他不愿意好好的这个跟着父辈的教训呢，好好去上学，好像用功了，啊，他就喜欢玩，是个野孩子，这个姚没有办法，啊，其他人想了各种措施管教不了这儿子，他就想办法。 把儿子这个引上一个正途，用什么办法来引呢？他儿子好玩，你跟他正面说教是没有用的，所以当时他就相传，然后就发明了一种围棋的游戏。
The smooth space of Go as against the straight space of chess. The nomos of Go against the state of chess, nomos against polis. The difference is that chess. Another justice, another movement, another space-time. They come like fate, without reason. Between the magical despotic state and the juridical state containing a military institution, we see the flash of the war machine arriving from without. From the standpoint of the state, the originality of the man of war his eccentricity necessarily appears in a negative form. Stupidity, deformity, madness, illegitimacy, usurpation, sin. The warrior is in the position of betraying everything, including the function of the military or of understanding nothing. It is not enough to affirm that the war machine is external to the apparatus. It is necessary to reach the point of conceiving the war machine as itself a pure form of exteriority, whereas the state apparatus constitutes the form of interiority we aptly take as a model or according to which we are in the habit of thinking. What complicates everything is that this extrinsic power of the war machine tends, under certain circumstances, to become confused with one of the two heads of the state apparatus. But a disturbing character like Richard III slips in, announcing from the outset his intention to reinvent a war machine and impose its line, deformed, treacherous, and traitorous. He claims a secret close intent, totally different from the conquest of state power, and another relation with women. One would have to say that it's located irreductibility. The state has no war machine of its own. It can only appropriate one in the form of a military institution, one that will continually cause it problems. Trapped between the two poles of political sovereignty, the man of war seems outmoded, condemned, without a filter, reduced to his own fury, which he turns against himself. The descendants of Hercules, Achilles, Then Ajax, having not the strength left to proclaim their independence from Agamemnon, a man of the old state. But they are powerless when it comes to Ulysses, a man of the nascent modern state, the first man of the modern state. And it is Ulysses who inherits Achilles' arms, only to convert them to other uses, submitting them to the laws of the state. Not Ajax, who is condemned by the goddess he defied and against whom he sinned. No one has portrayed the situation of the man of war, at once eccentric and condemned, better than placed. In Penthesilea, Achilles is already separated from his power. The war machine has passed over to the Amazons, a stateless woman people whose justice, religion, and loves are organized uniquely in a war mode. Descendants of the Scythians, the Amazons spring forth like lightning between the two states, the Greek and the Trojan. They sweep away everything in their path. Achilles is brought before his double, Penthesilea, and in his ambiguous struggle, Achilles is unable to prevent himself from marrying the war machine, or from loving Penthesilea, and thus from betraying Agamemnon and Ulysses at the same time. Nevertheless, he already belongs enough to the Greek state that Penthesilea, for her part, cannot enter the passional relation of war with him without herself betraying the collective law of her people. Throughout his work, Clace celebrates the war machine, setting it against the state apparatus in a struggle that is lost from the start. Doubtless, Arminius heralds a Germanic war machine that breaks with the imperial order. As for Colas, his war machine can no longer be anything more than banditry. Is it the destiny of the war machine when the state triumphs to be caught in this alternative, either to be nothing more than the disciplined military organ of the state apparatus, or to turn against itself? A catapulting force, love or hate, they are no longer feelings, but effects. And these effects are so many instances of the becoming. Effects transpierce their body like arrows. They are weapons of war. Catatonia is. This effect is too strong for me. And a flash is. The power of this effect sweeps me away. So, is the war machine already overtaken? Condemned, appropriated as part of the same process whereby it takes on new forms, undergoes a metamorphosis. The problem one says that, is there a way of warding off the formation of a state apparatus or its equivalents in a group? And the proposition two says that the exteriority of the war machine is also attested to by ethnology. Primitive segmentary societies have often been defined as societies without a state. In other words, societies in which distinctive organs of power do not appear. But the conclusion has been that this society is not a potential concern of primitive societies to ward off or avert that monster they supposedly do not understand. War. To be sure, primitive societies have chiefs. But the state is not defined by the existence of chiefs. It is defined by the perpetuation or conservation of organs of power. Clusters describe the situation of the chief, who has no instituted weapon other than his prestige, no other means of persuasion, no other rules than his sense of the group's desires. They identify war in primitive societies as the surest mechanism directed against the formation of the state. War maintains the dispersal and segmentarity of group and makes it impossible. It should not be concluded that war is a state of nature, but rather that it is the mode of a social state that wards off and prevents the state. Pretty easily seen in certain band or pack phenomena, for example, in this case of gangs of street children in Bogota. Jacques Menu cites three ways in which the leader is prevented from acquiring stable power. The members of the band meet and undertake their thrifty activity in common, with collective sharing of the loot, but they disperse to eat or sleep separately. Also, and especially, each member of the band is paired off with one, two, or three other members. So, if he has a disagreement with the leader, he will not live alone but will take along his allies, whose combined departure will threaten to break up the entire gang. These mechanisms cannot be understood without renouncing the evolutionist vision that sees bands or packs as a rudimentary, less organized social form. Even in bands of animals, leadership is a complex mechanism that does not act to promote the strongest, but rather inhibits the installation of stable powers. Eugene Sue, a man of high society and a dandy, whom legitimists reproached for frequenting the Orleans family, used it to say, "I'm not on the side of the family, I side with the pack." Packs, bands, are groups of his own type. Discipline is the characteristic required of arms after the state has appropriated them. The war machine answers to other roles. We are not saying that they are better, of course, only that they animate the fundamental indiscipline of the warrior. No doubt, the war machine is realized more completely in the barbaric assemblages of nomadic warriors than in the savage assemblages of primitive societies. In any case, it is out of the question that the state could be the result of a war in which the conquerors imposed, by the very fact of their victory, a new law on the vanquished. Algumas linhas de fuga pipocando. Então curta, se inscreva aqui no canal. Poste seus comentários aí. Não esqueça de curtir aqui no YouTube mesmo, que vai estar ajudando o nosso canal a crescer. Beijos.